is 2014 going to be an indecent election where foul is fair? Are we seeing an unprecedented low level of political discourse where no party is actually above crossing the lines of decency? Let's take a look at some of the statements at the election rallies that have created a political storm.
अगर आप पे कोई दम हो मैडम, आप बीमार हैं, तो आपके बेटे को काम दो।
उसे हमको बचाना है, खूनी इंसान से देश को।
चाय की दुकान से उठने वाले का तबड़ी नजरिया लास्टिंग नहीं। नरेंद्र मोदी कहते हैं मैं चाय जैसा समय प्रधानमंत्री बनना चाहता हूं, चाय जैसे वाले सिपाही को कप्तान बैठा दो, उसका नजरिया कभी कप्तान वाला नहीं होगा, नजरिया सिपाही वाला।
From Narendra Modi's Khuni Panja to Beni Prasad Verma's Khuni Insan. From Rahul Gandhi saying that the BJP incites communal riots to Naresh Agarwal saying a tea vendor can't become Prime Minister. What has happened to our political discourse? Is this reaching now a new low? And what can the Election Commission do to stop this? Joining us on the buck stops here, which we are broadcasting from Bhopal tonight, from the Congress, Senior Leader of the Congress, Abhishek Singhvi, from the BJP, Chandan Mitra of the BJP, and from the former election commissioner joining us from Delhi, S.Y. Qureshi. Abhishek Singhvi, let me start with you. Narendra Modi today made a passing reference to Sonia Gandhi's illness. The BJP would argue that he was merely articulating the argument that it's time for Rahul Gandhi to take charge of the party. Why has the Congress objected as fiercely as it has today?
Barkha, first of all, at the end of the day, there is no mechanism by which people can be stopped from behaving as their fitrat tells them to behave or to speak as their fitrat tells them to speak. At the end of the day, the model code of conduct is a largely consensual, nice, graceful, collective manner of agreeing to things, but it doesn't have teeth. And I don't think people expect that in the hurly-burly of election, in the less than 3 weeks to 4 weeks available, apart from an admonition, anything else will happen. So people will do it. Ultimately, I think people make an image of every politician and they slot you into that image. And if you keep on repeating it, much more than the admonition of the model code of conduct is that your own image with the people either suffers or improves. Now, as far as Mr. Modi is concerned, I think even his greatest admirers will privately concede that over the years, and this is not one swallow doesn't make a summer, over the years from Gujarat, from Michael Lingdo, James Michael Lingdo, to all the other comments, to the comments till today, personalized, vituperative, hitting below the belt. It is part of his style, it is part of his fitrat, and I don't think he's going to change. People are left to make their own decision. You may have one or two cases involving Rahul Gandhi, and let me end by half a minute, Barkha, by saying that even the order issued by the EC about Mr. Rahul Gandhi has made it clear that you should be more circumspect in the future. It's a very mild admonition because what he said clearly intended to in fact mean the opposite of what is ascribed to him. But the point of the matter is, Barkha, at the end of the day, this has to be left to the people to judge. And I think on that judgment, Mr. Modi's remarks, highly personalized, highly vituperative, frequently cross the boundaries completely. They are in bad taste, they are unparliamentary, and they are not what a good, mature democracy should see.
But Abhishek Singhvi, before I take that to Chandan Mitra, I have to ask you, the Congress went complaining to the Election Commission about Narendra Modi's Khuni Panja remark, his swipe at the Congress's hand symbol. But your own Beni Prasad Verma is today talking about a Khuni Insan. So how does the Congress get to call itself blameless?
No, look, let me tell you one thing clearly. Two wrongs can never make a right. I don't know about the remark you're talking about, but in case it is similar to or like what
we'll,
we are
we'll
criticizing.
We'll play it out for you.
I don't see any reason. No, no, I'm not here to defend that. Barkha, I would not. How can I defend something in case it is so, which is identical to what we are criticizing as far as Mr. Modi is concerned? But that particular one, we'll have to see the context. If the context doesn't change it and it is as bad as you say, well, then the same test has to apply. But I'm repeating, Mr. Modi has a tradition, a line, a lineage, a particular history, a track record. You don't build up this image of these remarks in one or two or even three remarks. It is over the last 10 years that you've seen them in Gujarat, in Delhi, in other election campaigns, and this time, after having been declared prime ministerial candidate, I think he seems to be doing an excess of it. The way he spoke in Chhattisgarh, I think if anybody wants to be a prime minister, to speak like this about mothers and sons and about it, I think it's very cheap. Very cheap.
Okay, Chandan Mitra, the word being used for Narendra Modi's comments today is cheap by Abhishek Singhvi. And I do have to ask you, is there no line that all politicians, in a sense, believe they should be behind? And I ask you this because was it fair to mention Sonia Gandhi's illness, which, as you saw, drew a titter from the crowd there when he said, Rahul Gandhi ko bete ko kaam de do, the crowd actually laughed, which means that somebody's illness became a joke. I'm particularly curious to know your response because here in Madhya Pradesh, traveling with Sushma Swaraj, who's also a very senior leader of your party, she actually said that language in these elections should always be decent and it's possible to be aggressive without being indecent. Was Mr. Modi indecent today, Chandan Mitra?
Well, firstly, I would say that what Sushma ji told you, I just saw the interview, I think it was very, very correct and appropriate. And Sushma ji herself and most of our party leaders have never crossed the line. As far as what Mr. Modi said today, Barkha, let me just recall a poster which congressmen put up in Allahabad and certain places in UP, a big poster which said, Mata rehti hai bimar, bete par bad raha hai bhar, and it was an appeal to bring in Priyanka Gandhi into the picture. Mata rehti hai bimar, bete par pad raha hai bhar. This is a line coined by congressmen. So, Congress should also take a certain share of responsibility for what has happened. And who started this whole process? I only wish to recall what Mrs. Sonia Gandhi had to say for Mr. Atal Bihari Vajpayee, who was one of the most, you know, polite, decent persons in our political history. She called him a nikamma. Yeah. She once said, Unka dimagi santulan bigad gaya hai. I mean, this, if the president of the Congress party uses this language, I think it really ill behoves of Mr. Abhishek Manu Singhvi to kind of lecture us as to how a prime ministerial candidate should speak.
But you know, Chandan, L.K. Advani also called Manmohan Singh a Nikamma prime minister. I remember that from 2009. So my point is that none of you are any different.
Well, you know, I personally feel that personal attacks should be kept away. You attack a party.
Yeah.
And for that reason, I would say that there is nothing wrong with what Mr. Modi said about Khuni Panja. The Congress has rushed to the election commission. From my childhood, I remember CPM's wall writings in Calcutta, which always said, Congress er khuni haath bhenge dao, guniye dao. Congress ka khuni haath, aap tod do, marod do, etc., etc. And this went on and on. So I don't think that was an attack on a party and a party's record. That must be distinguished from personal attacks, which unfortunately have become the norm. I would say it's best these things are avoided, but the discourse has got lowered over the years. You cannot blame politicians of all hues, whether it's Naresh Agarwal said, or what some Aam Aadmi Party fellow said in Delhi yesterday.
Yeah.
These are all unfortunate.
About the Home Minister.
But I think Sir, correctives must be brought inside.
Who's going to draw the line? Parties. Who's going to blink first and draw the line? Abhishek Singhvi, before I get S.Y. Qureshi in, you've got your hand up. The point Chandan Mitra is making is that if the Congress can refer to the Congress president's illness, and if Rahul Gandhi, for example, can talk about how his mother was not well when the food security bill had to be voted on, why can't Narendra Modi? What is the difference you were wanting to come in there?
Barkha, first of all, you cannot have double standards, and if there is an individual aberration in any party, you can't justify it by saying that the same is in any other party. I entirely agree. But 2 points. First of all, during Dr. Chandan Mitra's childhood, I don't think we had a model code of conduct at all, or if we did, we didn't have it this kind, because he can't be that young that we had a model code of conduct at that time. So let's not compare what the CPM did in the good old days when there was no election commission and no model code of conduct. Secondly, and more importantly, I find it amazing that the personalized, illness, cheap comment of Modi is justified by reference to a poster put up by persons who have been punished, who have been expelled or suspended, which is not something the Congress has approved of. So the standard for the BJP is the renegade
So what? Is that a congressman is not symptomatic of the Congress. The Congress is a far larger party than yours, Mr. Chandran Mitra. So a congressman in the remote corner, Mr. 1X, abuses Mrs. Sonia Gandhi. Do you think that gives the right to Mr. Narendra Modi to do the same? He's not a typical congressman.
What about
he's not a person we are approving of. He's not a leader. He's not a post holder. He's not somebody we've condoned. We haven't condoned. So don't apply standards which are not arise in the remote sense.
My mother is ill.
Now let's go further. Mr. Rahul Gandhi saying in the context of the food security bill, what actually transpired factually in parliament, does that compare not even like apples and oranges, but like Zameen and Asman with what Chhattisgarh saw today as far as Mr. Modi is concerned? Is there a comparison?
Yeah.
For God's sake, please play out
Chandran
the two. One
Mitra
is saying
wasn't it
what
said
happened
in, a joke.
In the food security
Mr.
bill.
Dr.
Let's
Qureshi
have some
is
sense
waiting.
Of balance and comparison.
Okay.